In November of 2016, when Caitlin was 9 years old, she was diagnosed with a Wilms tumor, which is a form of pediatric kidney cancer. At the time, she was complaining of a persistent stomach ache, so we brought her to Malta Med Urgent Care. And after several different tests, they determined that there was something that they saw that they didn't like, and they wanted to send us directly to Albany Med. We traveled to Albany Med in an ambulance, and then were very quickly admitted into the Children's Hospital at Albany Medical Center. From there, it was a grueling 10 days of tests and surgery and the beginning of treatment for the Wilms tumor. When we first were admitted to the hospital at Albany Medical Center, the Children's Hospital, did you have any idea what the gravity of the situation was, or kind of what you had to endure ahead?
Not at all. I didn't really know what cancer was, and I honestly just wanted to go home. Like, during all the tests, I was just worried about like what I was missing in school, and wanting to get back for auditioning for my school play, and just going back to how life was.
And then after surgery, were you scared, or did you think about that it was going to take time? Were you scared that it was going to hurt? What were your thoughts once you sort of did understand what the treatment was going to involve?
I was definitely scared. I was still a little like unsure of what I would endure, but I was definitely nervous for surgery.
I remember
being really anxious, and yeah, it was really scary.
Yeah, we had a lot of discussions with you, making sure that you knew that you were in the best place, getting mm-hmm. the best care, the doctors and the nurses, and really everyone at Albany Med and even Malta Urgent Care were very, they made me feel very confident, and Dad and I very confident in the kind of care that you were getting, and that was a good feeling as parents. When you were at Malta Med, the PA there was the one who really pushed all the tests when we had to stay there for the entire day, basically. Mm-hmm. You know, you went there with a stomach ache, and we left there going to Albany Medical Center. But his name was Bob, and mm-hmm. he just kept pushing, knowing that something wasn't quite right, and he wanted to do another test and another test. Mm-hmm. And I don't know if you know this, but when you were in the hospital, right around the time of your surgery, maybe a day or two after, he tracked me down. He called my cell phone, and he just said, "I wanted to check on you, and wanted to check on your daughter, and she's been on my mind, and I've been, you know, saying prayers for you." And I just thought that was very touching, that mm-hmm. that he, you know, really cared. What were the things that, during the 6 or 7 months of treatment that you went through when you were, you know, 9 and 10 years old, what were the things that kind of kept you feeling like you?
Definitely musical theater, performing as young Simba in The Lion King at my elementary school. I remember finding out about the cast list when I was having treatment at the hospital, and it got sent out, and I found out that I got young Simba, and I was really excited.
Do you remember what you said to me when I showed you the cast list on my phone? You're getting treatment, you're getting your chemo treatment, and you said, you started to tear up, and you said, I'm the luckiest girl in the world.
Yeah, I just felt really excited and like supported by everyone, and honestly, like, the being able to play the character young Simba, it helped me kind of like feel brave, I guess, because like the character is like brave and like, I don't care what people think, kind of. So it was like a fun like mindset to be in, and it actually kind of like helped me feel like the character, I guess, mm-hmm. and not really feel like nervous or anything. Like, I just felt like mm-hmm. brave throughout the time, yeah. If you always take it to the chin and balance, you might as well be saying you think that it's okay, and that's not right. I had loved to sing ever since I was little. Like, when I was like 2 or 3, I would perform Annie for you guys.
Anyone.
and sing Tomorrow. So yeah, theater just has been a big part. I don't know, I just have always loved it and loved singing. And
as a mom, that was also very good to see, is mm-hmm. just you being you, even though you were going through, our family, we were all going through, but mm-hmm. you were going through something really hard, just mm-hmm. seeing you continue to do all the things that, you know, you mentioned.
That I love to do and stuff. Yeah. It's honestly surprising, though, like, how I still had energy to, like, do so yeah. much. Like, I...
You were tired. You took a lot of naps.
Lots of naps.
You snuggled with Riley a lot. Mm-hmm. Your dog.
I was extremely grateful for all the support from my school and from my friends and teachers. Everyone was, like, very yeah. comforting and wanted to make sure I felt comfortable and just wanted me to feel the best that I could yeah. I could feel.
Your school was amazing, Dorothy Nolan, mm-hmm. and all the teachers and administrative staff mm-hmm. and your friends and the families. They were such a huge support. 6 years past the end of your treatment, past when you rang that bell to say that your treatment was over. Do you have any advice or words of wisdom for a kid who might be, you know, facing that, you know, going through the treatment? With you sitting here as a almost 16-year-old, you know, doing very, very well, what would you say to them?
To find things that make you happy, that will help you get through, like, this hard time. And even though it is a, like, challenging and not fun at all experience, just to find little things in life that are like find the good things.
I agree. As a mom I would say the same, that if you let yourself go down that rabbit hole, like, that's not a good place to be. Mm-hmm. Focus on all the positive
and just do what you love. Like, for me,
the
theater.
Around you.
Like,
yeah. Well, for me, theater. I distracted myself doing all your costumes for mm-hmm. The Lion King, which was an amazing distraction because it was, you know, something to focus on, and watching you up there doing what you love was made me as a mom grateful that you weren't always focused on the cancer, that there was mm-hmm. other things that. To your life, and you kept it that way, and mm-hmm. that I was very proud of you. What is life like right now as a 16-year-old cancer survivor?
Pretty average, I feel like, pretty normal. I mean, being a cancer survivor definitely helps my perspective on things. Like, just remembering that I am a cancer survivor helps me, like, feel braver, I guess, and like knowing that I went through that, so I can like do anything now, I feel like.
Yeah, as a mom, that's about the best thing that I could have envisioned, is that you're sitting here as just a kind and smart and successful and brave 16-year-old, and we are so proud of you, and thinking about getting here during the times when you were in treatment is, you know, what motivated us. It's, you don't realize how fragile kind of life is until something like this happens, mm-hmm. and just looking at what a wonderful, you know, young woman that you're becoming is really inspirational, and that you use the cancer as kind of a driving force to remind you mm-hmm. how brave you are and what you did endure and what you did go through. It's just, it makes me really proud.